Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. This episode is a corollary to the episode Stop Using Const Cast. Now that episode, I got some pushback from people. And well, I'm going to explain what pushback was that I got in this episode and show you a workaround. All right, so the comment that I got from people was, let's say I've got some struct, my always cleverly named struct S. Now, it is common in designing our classes in C++ that we're going to have both const and non-const member functions. And generally speaking, they do basically the same thing, but sometimes we have a reason to call the const or the non-const version explicitly. Now, calling the non-const version is generally easy. You just have to have a non-const object to call it on. So I'm going to make something that's not really a very realistic example, but one that will illustrate my point. These things are totally valid. I am allowed to return a string view of a const character string literal because that is valid for the lifetime of the program. So I'm creating an object called little s here, and I am calling the get value member function here. Just as a technical aside, C++ doesn't technically have methods. They are member variables and member functions, but that is a very pedantic aside. So I've got this get value and get value const, and we can see that it is calling the non-const version. I have that printed on the screen in the bottom right here. If I were to declare this as const, then I should get the word const printed down here. There we go. Once it is executed, I get the const printed. And that's because this object was declared const. And then I am calling implicitly the const overload of this member function getValue down here on line 18. But let's say I have a non-const object. And I need to call the const version of this member function. One way that I could do that is explicitly creating a const reference. So now I have this const view of this thing. So S is a const reference to this non-const object. The original object was not created as const in the first place, but now that I have this const view of it, I'm back to getting const being printed out here when I call it now on line 21. So the pushback that I got from viewers was people who wanted to do this saying, well, I have to use const cast when I want to add const. And it is true that you could do this. You could do this const cast ampersand here. And now we're going to explicitly be calling the const overload of the function. It is also equally true that I could have called static cast here. Now, const cast is a very big hammer in that it can remove const. And if you watched the last episode, you can see that that can actually be very dangerous in our code. Static cast, interestingly, is also kind of a big hammer because it can invoke implicit and explicit conversions. So just for the fun of it, I'm going to create a constructor for s that takes an int, and this is an implicit conversion. I can make this explicit so that, generally speaking, we want our single parameter constructors to be explicit so that we never accidentally have implicit conversions from like an int to this const thing. So now that I've got a static cast, I can actually pass a 1 in here. And this is going to invoke the implicit conversion if I accidentally forget to put the ampersand here and make it a reference. And in either case, we're getting this const called. So the static cast can invoke this implicit conversion. Let's comment this out so the full program compiles again. Now I have this unused local variable s. So static cast can invoke these conversions. Const cast can remove const, which we don't want. It cannot invoke conversions, which is definitely a good thing. But really what we want is just to add const. A very easy way to do that is to write this handy little function called asconst. And this way I can pass in this object s and I get back a const reference. Now note I'm taking this by const reference because I don't care if the thing that was passed into me already is a const reference. I just want to return a const reference back out. And you can always add const implicitly. If we couldn't, all manner of functions would not work as expected. Adding const is always an implicit thing that can happen. So this code compiles just fine. Now, this would be a little bit of a pain to actually have to write for every single class that we needed this for. So you could just as easily write a quick template function and get exactly the same thing here. And we're still getting const printout as expected. Now, fortunately, you are not the first person to have this problem, and I am not the first person to describe the solution. And we can see in C++ 17 that we got asconst added to the standard library. It is a quite a bit more robust version than I have implemented. It is in the utility header, which is probably already implicitly included for me. But now I can call this as standard as const. So there you go. If you were still holding out and saying, I must use const cast because I am needing to add const to an object, which, you know, I must say is actually a very rare scenario to be in. The standard library does have this handy helper function for you. And if you are not yet in C++ 17 land, then it's fine. Just write your own quick template function to do the same thing. So as always, thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe. If you enjoyed the episode, give it a thumbs up. That's actually really important. And leave your thoughts below as to what you thought about asconst and if this is a scenario you have found yourself in.